Your dream garden presents. Plant hoppers of rice. The current world population is 7.8 billion. Expected to increase to 9.7 billion by the year 2050. Present population of India is 1.38 billion, second highest in the world. Wheat and rice are the major staple food crops for the ever-growing population. World rice production is 495 million metric tons. India is the second largest producer of rice in the world, 116 million metric tons. Loss in rice due to pests and diseases is 38% per annum. Over $300 million loss occurs in rice due to plant hoppers. Averting yield losses due to plant hoppers is the present challenge. I worked at Indian Institute of Rice Research in collaboration with scientists for over 35 years to manage these important rice insect pests. This presentation is my humble effort to share my experiences in handling these insect pests, which may be useful to the rice workers and farmers. Plant hoppers of rice: brown plant hopper, Nelaparotha lugens, and white-backed plant hopper, Sogatella furcifera. Classification and characteristics: Kingdom Animalia, multicellular organisms, heterotrophic, phylum Arthropoda, presence of exoskeleton, jointed limbs, segmented body, bilateral symmetry. Class Insecta, a three-part body: head, thorax, and abdomen. Three pairs of jointed legs, compound eyes, and one pair of antennae. Order Hemiptera, plant feeders, they suck plant juices. Family Delphacidae, small insects with the piercing, sucking mouth parts. Plant hoppers suck plant sap by inserting the stylet or proboscis. Distribution of plant hoppers: they occur mainly in Asian tropical countries like China, Korea, Japan, Vietnam, Myanmar, Laos, Thailand, Cambodia, the Philippines, Malaysia, Indonesia, Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, Pakistan, and India. Distribution of plant hoppers in India: Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Odisha, West Bengal, Jharkhand, Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, Haryana, and Punjab. Mostly, the plant hoppers are specific to rice. However, they are also found feeding on grasses like Lyrtia alexandra during off-season. The plant hoppers are dimorphic, have two morphologically distinct forms, one Macropterus form, two Brachypterus form, Macropterus adults with long and fully developed wings. Brachypterus adults with short and half developed wings.
WB page males are rare.
The adults measure about 4 to 6 mm in length and 3 to 4 mm in width.
WBPH, Brachypterus male adults are rare.
Gravid females introduce their ovipositor into the leaf sheath to lay eggs.
We can see clearly how both BPH and WBPH Brachypterus gravid females introduce their ovipositor into the leaf sheath and lay eggs. Macropterus gravid female adult laying eggs. Ovipositional marks. BPH eggs are not visible, whereas WBPH eggs are visible to the naked eye. Developed eye spots are also can be noticed.
Eggs are white, elongated, and look like a curved club.
They hatch in about 6 to 9 days.
It is amazing to watch nymphs wriggling out after the egg hatch.
Newly hatched nymphs are cottony white in color. They turn purple brown within an hour. They pass through 5 instars before becoming adults. First instar nymphs, second instar nymphs, third instar nymphs, fourth and fifth instar nymphs finally become adults. Nymphs and adults congregate at the base of the plant to suck the plant sap from the stem and leaf sheath. As a result, leaves turn yellow initially and later brownish due to drying up of the plants. If damage is severe, field gives a burnt appearance in concentric circles known as hopper burn.
Please see the hopper excretion, which I could record after several hours of keen observation and failures.
Sooty molds develop due to honeydew secretions by plant hoppers. Reasons for pest buildup.
Temperature and relative humidity play a crucial role in the development of these plant hoppers. Temperature 25 to 30 degrees Celsius and a relative humidity more than 70%.
Excessive use of nitrogenous fertilizer. Closer crop canopy. Indiscriminate usage of pesticides which eliminate the natural enemies. Continuous submerged condition in the field. Preventive measures. Use resistant varieties. Provide alleyways or pathways. Follow package of practices recommended for the variety. Need-based use of pesticides as per recommendations. Drain out water from the field on and off. Remove weeds from the field and surroundings regularly. I thank all the directors, heads of sections, scientists and technical staff, and those of entomology section in particular for their constant encouragement throughout my career.
I profusely thank the skilled and unskilled workers who were with me all through. Thanks are due to Dr. J.S. Prasad and Dr. Gururaj Katti for sharing their ideas in making this presentation. If you like this video, please click on the like button and share it to your friends. Please don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching this video.
Save me from pests. I will save you from starvation.